a minute of silence in commemoration of the victims of the ongoing pandemic here in South America. Some last minute knots to tie up before we get underway. And we're off. Lautaro Martinez gets the ball rolling. 29th meeting in the Copa America between these two sides, who, as I mentioned earlier, played the second ever Copa America match in the inaugural tournament back in 1916. Chile, somewhat surprisingly, they've never managed to beat Argentina in the Copa America. They have, of course, recorded two draws, which later went to shootouts and resulted in the triumphs in the finals of the 2015 and 2016 Copas. Argentina have managed 20 wins and 8 draws over the course of the 90 minutes in meetings between these two sides, and will, of course, be hoping that that continues. Time for Chile to try and break the hoodoo. Eugenio Mena with the throw-in, trying to find Edu Vargas. But Gonzalo Montiel isn't having any of it. Frantic in the early stages, but Chile trying to stroke the ball around and settle. This is Eric Pulgar. Now making inroads down the left. But Jean Menezes is brought down, and Wilmar Roldan says that's a foul. Not impressed with Leandro Paredes. Too many arguments there. Mena with the throw. Vargas comes to get it. Offloads to Charles Aránguiz, who's brought down. I'm guessing that Palacios' idea early on is to let Chile know that he's there. He has a reputation as a slightly more cerebral, deep-lying midfielder. And Chile in recent years have certainly known how to get under Argentina's skin. Aránguiz sends the free kick in. Otamendi's underneath it and hinted away at the second time of asking. That's going to be an Argentina free kick as Giovanni Lo Celso, the Tottenham man, is bundled over. Montiel across to Otamendi. Looking for Messi there, but it's been cut out. And this is Mena over for Gary Medel. Maripan to Mena. Nice little knock from Aránguiz. And Mena's tried to release Vargas, but Emiliano Martinez comes and deals with it. I think Vargas is offside anyway. Emiliano is one of four Argentina players with the surname Martinez in their squad for this Copa America. Three of them are on the pitch. Lucas Martinez Cuarta is one of the centre-backs just in front of him. And of course, Lautaro Martinez leading the line. The other, the Ajax defender, Lisandro Martinez, is on the bench today. Montiel dispossessed, and Chile build again from the back. Is Maripan. For Palacios. As Isla in support. Aranguiz now, conducting from deep. Meneses trying to twist and turn, but he ends up being bundled off the ball. Paredes finds Montiel. And there's Messi's first touch of the game, I think. Lo Celso trying to put Mena under pressure. Maripan, sorry. Chile manager Martín Lasarte. Pulgar to Aranguiz. He's got Meneses, I think, ahead of him, but he was asking an awful lot of him there. Montiel, Vargas is on this, twists and tries to play Mena down the left, but it's dealt with by Argentina. De Paul. Messi didn't have enough in support, and now Chile can break. Here's Arturo Vidal, excellently blocked out by Otamendi. And Pulgar. A nice ball from deep, but it's easily claimed by Martinez. Argentina have a free kick. I think the referee is indicating a hand was used there by Eric Pulgar to knock the ball away from Messi. Otamendi. Now for Nicolas Tagliafico to Nicolas Gonzalez, who wins the throw. Paredes, all the way back to Otamendi. Argentina at the moment, I'm sure, will just be looking to try and settle on the ball a bit, try and have a spell of possession, because Chile have had the better of this very, very early running. There's Messi dropping deep and looking for Gonzalez, who looks outside and then goes inside. Oh, and here's Tagliafico down for Messi. It's the first shot of the match. But it's a long way wide. Not quite up to the standards he expects of himself. Wonderful ball from, I think it was Rodrigo de Paul. Bravo didn't appear interested in playing his short at all there. He told everybody to just get up pitch. Here's Vargas. Down for Palacios. And Gary Medel has to step in there and find Mena on the left. Aranguiz to Maripan, back to Medel, and Chile going backwards after initially starting off going forwards. Aranguiz to Maripan again. All the way back to Claudio Bravo, former Manchester City goalkeeper. Spent the last season with Real Betis in La Liga. Well, De Paul's underneath that. He didn't win it, but it's fallen for Lautaro Martinez, whose ball didn't quite reach Lionel Messi. It's very well cut out indeed, by Eric Pulgar. Montiel with the throw. Gets it to De Paul. Paredes. De Paul. Gonzalez has come a long way in field there. Otamendi, and now it's Argentina's turn to go all the way back to the centre-backs and recycle possession. Martinez Cuarta. Lovely ball for Nicolas Tagliafico, who at the second time of asking gets it to Gonzalez. Giovanni Lo Celso. Here's Messi. Where's De Paul? Oh, it's Van Montiel in space for Montiel's pass. Just a little behind Lo Celso. And Carlos Palacios can't keep the ball in play. Palacios, one of two Chileans who plays his club football here in Brazil. He plays for Internacional of Porto Alegre down in the south. The other is the number 11, hanging around near the player with the ball at the moment, Eduardo Vargas, who plays for Atlético Mineiro. Gonzalez goes one way, then cuts inside him, jinks forward, and Messi, oh, tried to find Lautaro Martinez, but there was a slip. Chile can clear. Paredes to Lo Celso, driving forward, or driving to the left anyway. And that's a hopeful ball in. Martinez was almost there. And it's very nicely turned away. Nicely turned away by Guillermo Maripan. Who needed to get that just right. Lautaro Martinez, if he scores today, will have exactly a 1-in-2 goals to game ratio for Argentina. Vidal now, looking to, oh, he's not hit it long. Back inside and across to Pulgar, who will look for Mena, but he just had to arrest his run a bit there. Pulgar didn't play it in front of him. And he decides to give it back to Pulgar. Now Charles Aránguiz. Give and go with Gian Menezes, but Martinez Cuarta cuts that out. Mena for Aránguiz with the throw. Maripán to Medel. And the ball's run loose and Giovanni Lo Celso's come away with it. Getting forward, getting it to Messi, who brings it under his spell. And looks for Martinez, Lautaro Martinez, I should say. But it's a long way in front of him. All the same, Argentina have got a corner. Apparently Claudio Bravo touched that before it went out. Oh, in fact, it's come off Maripán and Bravo was trying to stop it from going out. Short corner to De Paul and gives it back to Messi. And that's a decent ball in. It was Martinez Cuarta who got his head on it, but he didn't know much about it. And Chile will be able to clear. Medel looking for Vargas, but the Mineiro man can't get on it. But Gian Menezes now has this coming down the left. And it's Van Palacios. No, he's not. Otamendi very sharply in there to put behind. Not all Argentina fans are delighted with Nicolas Otamendi's inclusion in the starting lineup today. But his experience and ability to read the game put to good use there. Charles Aránguiz will be taking the corner for Chile. No, pulling towards the penalty spot, and it's headed away. Back to halfway, where Mauricio Isla will decide where to send it next. This is Meneses, going to come in from the left, down to Pulgar. And that's a fairly easy one for Argentina to cut out, but it's, again, straight down the throats of Chile's attack. Vidal to Palacios. Oh, and this slice behind Martinez Cuarta will be grateful to Emiliano Martinez, and perhaps grateful to good fortune that that didn't go pretty much anywhere else, really. Bell to Otamendi as Argentina look to build again from the back. Martinez Cuarta. Tagliafico now down the left. Inside for Lo Celso to Nico Gonzalez. Oh, and it's a good save from Bravo. He had to be sharp to that one. These two sides met about a week and a half ago in World Cup qualifying, and Bravo pulled off a couple of really nice saves, one from a Messi free kick. He's not getting any younger, but he's still got the reactions. So Messi across to take the corner for Argentina. In 6 yard box. Oh! And it's almost in. Nico Gonzalez, I don't think he's the tallest player on the pitch, but he jumped well to get there. Unfortunately for Argentina, he couldn't get it on target. Maripán closed down. It's deflected, I think, but it's not gone out yet. Yeah, no, it has. Oh, it wasn't deflected. It's an Argentina throw. Gonzalo Montiel trotting back to take it. Montiel back for Martinez Cuarta. Now Leandro Paredes. Picks up Lautaro Martinez. Now Giovanni Lo Celso looking to spread it, and he's released Gonzalez through the middle. Well held by Bravo. Gonzalez will be disappointed. His finish was perhaps a bit too close to the goalkeeper. And Bravo's going to win some time. Really nice pass from Lo Celso. But Gonzalez had the goal to pick from, you could say. He's being put under a bit of pressure. And just rushed things a bit. It seems Bravo really is in a little bit of pain. I apologise to him. Nice view of the stadium there. This stadium was known as the Engenhão for a long time, after the area of Rio that it's in. It was officially renamed in 2017 after Nilton Santos, one of the greatest footballers in Brazil's storied history, winner of the 1958 and 62 World Cups, and a teammate of Garrincha at club and national team level. Gonzalez. Lo Celso finds Martinez. He's got Messi helping him. Martinez Cuarta now. I'm not really sure what he thought he was doing that. Rush of blood to the head. Bravo will allow Chile to build from the back. Eugenio Mena. Vargas dropping deep. Back to Maripán, and Gary Medel now with it. Maripán's forced to take it back to Bravo, who sidesteps Lautaro Martinez. Tries to find Meneses, who gets it for the second attempt. Mena to Pulgar, to Meneses, to Vargas, to Pulgar, who spreads the play now. And Nico Gonzalez nods out with Mauricio Isla waiting just under him, had he not got there. A few seconds there where neither of Chile's centre-backs had very many options. Argentina won it. Almost immediately, a challenge to just shut down the attack before it could start. I have to say, it didn't look ineffective. Martinez Cuarta. Gonzalo Montiel. Vargas. I'm not sure that was quite what he tried to do, but Chile have continued with the ball anyway. Here's Meneses now down the left. And Montiel gives away the free kick. Martinez Cuarta gives away the free kick. No, he doesn't. He drew the free kick, in fact. Just offside. That's Emiliano Martinez, Nicolas Otamendi, when it runs to him. And Martinez Cuarta. To Otamendi. Tagliafico on another of those runs forward. It's a not a badly placed cross, but there was nobody running into the space for it. Oh, that's a nice touch from De Paul, though. I'm sure he'd think it would be nicer if Messi had actually managed to get on the end of it. Asking a bit too much of him. Martinez Cuarta, that's a loose pass, but it's not going to harm Argentina because Leandro Paredes was alive to the danger. And Emiliano Martinez gets things going again. Nicolas Otamendi. Trying to find his options. Paredes. Martinez Cuarta. Otamendi. Martinez Cuarta. Montiel. To Messi. He finds De Paul, who's going outside, taking a couple with him, but can't find Montiel on the underlap. Otamendi. To Martinez Cuarta, Montiel. Salas finds Montiel. It's all a bit flat-paced at the moment. Chile, very well organised. They're playing a back four today, but they're also very used to playing a back three against other opponents, and they're using that ability of Mena to, and Isla to work almost as auxiliary centre-backs to really make themselves hard to break down when Argentina are in any kind of lengthy phase of possession. Martinez to Martinez Cuarta to Gonzalez, I think, and Otamendi now comes forward for Argentina. Messi looking for the run from Gonzalez. He's going to get there and he's going to draw the free kick. after a perhaps slightly later than expected whistle from Mr. Roldan. And Mauricio Isla picks up, I believe, the first yellow card of the match. I don't think he can have too many arguments there. It was certainly late, it was rather high as well. Messi will take, of course, as always for Argentina. Claudio Bravo telling his defenders to keep an eye on something. There is Messi, and it's to the near post, but it's well dealt with by Chile. Nicolas Otamendi had to plough through a couple of people to get to that one, and he managed it, but very difficult to do without fouling them. Gary Medel, the unfortunate victim. Chile looking for Edu Vargas. He's managed to knock it down to Sean Meneses. Meneses has got the shot off, but it's always going wide. I think Emiliano Martinez knew that. He jumped for it. It wasn't an awfully long way wide, but it was with the angle. Best hope was probably that Vargas had a sudden burst of speed and managed to get on the end of it, but that was not going to happen. Martinez has mishit that one badly. And Pulgar has the chance to start things off for Chile. Here's Mena. Maripan. Medel to Vidal. Pass was a bit loose, but Vidal's got it back and gives it to Pulgar. Zarangis. No, it wasn't, it was Meneses, sorry. Anyway, Argentina have the free kick. Rodrigo de Paul to Nicolas Otamendi. But Messi has been dropping quite deep these last 5 minutes or so. Martinez finds Montiel on the right. He's got de Paul in support. But they're forced to take it back to Martinez Cuarta. And here's Messi. Twisting and turning and trying to find a way through. Uses Paredes. Now Lo Celso has a bit more space to work in. Finds Messi. Pel to Martinez Cuarta. Centre-backs, both of these teams know how to keep hold of the ball. Until you get a straight pass like that from Martinez Cuarta, makes it difficult to win it back. Here's Vargas. Like Messi dropping deep for his team to try and create something. And he's drawn a foul. And he's drawn the second yellow card of the game. Handed to Lisan Lucas Martinez Cuarta. Arturo Vidal having a word with Charles Aránguiz before the latter takes this free kick. Aránguiz looking at the far post and it's gone right the way across and Chile couldn't get anybody on the end of it. In the end, there's a flag up for offside. Paredes. Lo Celso lets it run, but he's let it run straight to Mauricio Isla. Chile can build and, well, same thing again. I don't think that one was quite as deliberate initially, but Martinez Cuarta leaves it for Martinez, who's trying to find Martinez. See, I told you there were lots of them for Argentina. Lo Celso brought down from behind. And I think we're going to see another name in the book now. That of Eric Pulgar, Fiorentina defensive midfielder. Had to take one for the team, really. That was a threatening situation for Argentina. Gian Lo Celso should be all right. So this is a, having prevented one threatening situation, Chile now have to face another, because this is very much within Lionel Messi's range. In that World Cup qualifier just under 2 weeks ago, as I said earlier, he forced one very nice save from Claudio Bravo in the first half, and in the second he left Bravo standing and hit the outside of the upright with another free kick from a very similar position. They were both perhaps just a little bit to the right of this as Messi's looking at it, but very similar distance. One of the first free kicks I've seen for a while, at least in South America, where they've not got anybody lying down behind the wall to stop the taker from rolling it under. Become increasingly common sight. So Messi to take, over the wall, and it's in! Argentina lead 1-0! Brilliant from Lionel Messi, that's what you expect of him. And that is precisely why you can't give them free kicks in those areas. Lionel Messi extends his record as Argentina's all-time top scorer. He's also, you've just seen a tiny bit of history, because he is now out on his own with 39 goals in competitive matches, which takes him ahead of Gabriel Batistuta as Argentina's all-time record holder for that as well. It's his 73rd goal overall, including friendlies, in his 145th cap. So just a smidgen better than 1 in 2. Wonderful free kick. So if Chile are going to get that elusive first Copa America win over Argentina, they will have to come from behind to do it as we get back underway. Gary Medel de Mauricio Isla. Back to Claudio Bravo. Nico Gonzalez bringing it under control well, but then really helping Chile out a bit with that pass. And they've got the ball back. Mena inside to Pulgar. Vidal back to Pulgar. Pulgar to Vidal. Palacios was muscled off it, but Chile have retained possession. No, they've not. Roldan seems to be indicating an Argentina free kick. There was a coming together when the ball ran loose after Palacios' touch, sorry. Oh yeah, that's a bit cynical from Vidal on Nicolas Otamendi. And Vidal's the third name in the book. It wouldn't be an Argentina-Chile match if it weren't just a little bit of an undercurrent of violence in there. They've become rather tetchy affairs in recent years in World Cup qualifying and in the Copa America, something of a grudge match, of course, from Argentina's point of view, especially following the 2015 and 2016 finals. Of course, Vidal will protest that, but I don't think he can have any really serious argument. Otamendi's back up under his own steam. It'll be Paredes to take the free kick to get things going again. Sent it to the goal scorer, Messi. There's a lovely pass for Gonzalo Montiel down the right, but for the second time tonight, Montiel's cross is a little disappointing and a nice, easy gift wrap one for Chile to deal with. Here's Meneses. He's dispossessed. Messi's come away with it. Gets it back to Martinez Cuarta. Paredes. Nicolas Otamendi. Tagliafico. Gonzalez tries to set Tagliafico away, but he's not your same Bolt. Rebel de Maripan to get things underway again. Oh, that was loose, and Messi's onto it. He's got Montiel outside, but he's going in instead. Here is Montiel, it's loose, and it's Lautaro Martinez, and it's very well blocked by Mauricio Isla. Martinez making the most of the contact. I don't think he's getting a penalty for it. If I was Chile's defensive coach, just looking at that angle, I'd be rather upset with Gary Medel because he was playing everybody onside there. And having seen that last replay, I think I said a minute ago that Isla had done well to block it, but he didn't in fact get near it, did he? I think Lautaro Martinez's reaction is more to hide his own embarrassment at scuffing the ball than anything else. So it's a goal kick for Chile. Well, Bravo doesn't seem very happy with his options here, does he? There's no way he's playing for time, given that they're goal down. And Otamendi regains possession for Argentina, who have another free kick. Martin Lasarte, Chile's Uruguayan manager, does not seem overly happy with his charges at the moment. Here's Messi, back to Paredes. To Messi, He's going to drive forward. He's almost held off Edu Vargas there, but in the end, he's drawn the foul. Paredes will again take the free kick. Oh no, he won't. That's to Paul and Messi standing over it. Paredes has decided to have a wander forward to the edge of the box. The ball sends it in. Martinez hits it, but it's come straight back off Vidal. And Chile now have a free kick due to an Argentine foul right after they regain possession. Another look at the free kick. A pretty central position. Messi gets it right into the corner of the net. Bravo got a hand to it, but there's not an awful lot you can do about that. Wilmar Roldan seems to be being told something. Someone's having a word in his ear. I noticed, I think it was Rodrigo de Paul, when the free kick was given, was claiming that there was a handball somewhere. Perhaps when Martinez's shot hit Vidal. If that is what they're checking, and if it is judged to be a handball, then it would be a penalty for Argentina, so this could be a big moment. Oh, it's at the previous, it's at the, after the ball went loose. And we're playing on. Bravo goes long, Argentina win it back, but Chile have... Oh, Chile were offside. Somebody from Chile. Paredes looking long to Lautaro Martinez. Gonzalez was distracting a little, but... Chile regained the ball, and Gary Medel wins the throw of Nicolas Gonzalez. Isla de Vidal, and it's gone loose. Martinez into De Paul. Argentina have it back. Across to Martinez Cuarta. 2 minutes to go until half-time. Montiel back to Martinez Cuarta. And Emiliano Martinez just gets it out of there. Eric Pulgar, that's a lovely first touch. Claudio Bravo. Looking long, and we're now going a bit frantic. Gio Lo Celso to Montiel, to Martinez Cuarta. Paredes, Montiel. Martinez Cuarta back to Martinez. I do apologise for not saying the two Martinez's first names all the time, by the way, but since one of them's at centre forward and the other's in goal, I presume that you can tell the difference. Medel back to Bravo. There's Mena. No, it's not. Sorry, it's Maripán. Pulgar. Bravo. Looking long to Isla, but Nicolás González cuts it out. I think he's hurt himself on the landing, but we're playing on Isla with a very loose ball, and Emiliano Martínez is able to run onto it. He's just letting the referee know that Argentina have a man down. And he'll throw it out. It was that ball just a moment ago from Claudio Bravo looking for Mauricio Isla, and Nicolás González has done well to win it, but Isla just went in under him. He didn't really make an attempt to jump. As a result, González has come down right on the base of his spine. Well, Chile have it back now. Charles Aránguiz to Eugenio Mena, back with Aránguiz. Medel. For Vidal. All the way back to Bravo, who's got Lautaro Martinez in pursuit. Medel. Oh. I'm not sure whether Martinez slipped or whether that really was an attempt at a rugby tackle, but it's a free kick for Chile. There was a bit of talk yesterday that the playing surface isn't the sturdiest condition at the moment. Oh, he does slip, doesn't he? Yeah. Bravo across to Maripán. We've got 3 minutes of extra time. We've had one of them already. Mena into Meneses. Back to Aránguiz. And Aránguiz has released Mena down the left. But he's got Rodrigo de Paul in close pursuit, and, well, Mena thinks he deserves a corner for that. Argentina, of course, disagree, and Wilmar Roldán agrees with Argentina. I have to say, I thought it came off de Paul. That was my initial reaction. Emiliano Martinez won't be in any rush at all, of course, to take this free kick. Goal kick. Gets a rather better connection on it than the one earlier. Paredes' header was straight back at Chile, but there was a little push from Martinez on Medel off the ball there. Roldán appears unhappy with Chile for taking that free kick a little too quickly. I don't think you can blame them. Medel to Maripán to Mena. Back to Maripán. Medel. And the referee calls time at the end of a first half that's been a little tetchy in parts, sometimes a little disconnected, but marked by that magnificent free kick from Lionel Messi to give Argentina a 1-0 lead at the break in Rio de Janeiro. Thank you.
Thank you.
So we're back for the second half. Here in the Nilton Santos. Argentina making their way back out. As I was checking my notes at half time, also realised that Lionel Messi's goal now sends him to the top of Argentina's free kick scoring charts. He was previously tied with Juan Román Riquelme on 6 goals from free kicks each for their country. But that, if I've counted correctly, makes it 7 for Messi. It wouldn't be Lionel Messi match if there wasn't a record of some sorts up for grabs, would it? So Martin Lasarte will have had some stern words for Chile's players at the break. And it will be Chile who get us underway for the second half once Wilmar Roldán has confirmed that everything is in order. Back underway. Mena, Maripán, and Medel were settling into a familiar pattern. Mena for Meneses, who lays it back off to the wing back, and now Arturo Vidal's come and tries to release Meneses down the left, but Otamendi is alive to it. Vidal. Charles Aránguiz lifting it over for Vidal and getting it straight back. It's Pulgar. Trying the 1-2. I think this is about as far up the pitch as Eric Pulgar has been all match. Isla now driving inside through the middle and finding Mena on the opposite flank. Montiel's block. But it's Mena who comes away with it. Montiel. Enjoyable little tussle. Maripán for Medel with Lautaro Martinez closing down. Goes all the way back to Claudio Bravo. Well, Charles Aránguiz was coming under pressure from Lionel Messi there. Messi doesn't have the reputation for closing players down too frantically, but I'm wondering whether Scaloni's had a word with Argentina's whole side to try and get at Chile very early on in this second half to see whether they can apply the pressure of the clock that's counting down. Isla, very unimpressed with what he clearly feels is some slightly lax refereeing, but Medel will take the free kick for Chile. No, he won't. Charles Aránguiz has told him to get up the pitch and has put it straight at Rodrigo de Paul. Otamendi's header away. Lo Celso misses the clearance, but Vargas has sold his teammate short there. Now Chile have recycled. Argentina couldn't counter. Meneses. Oh, Montiel didn't get on it. And neither did Meneses. I think Meneses was half expecting Montiel already to block the pass out and ended up just getting caught a bit flat-footed when the River Plate man didn't. Argentina have a free kick for a foul on Messi. Roldan just asking Lautaro Martinez to calm down a little bit. De Paul with the free kick, the Udinese midfielder. He's looking for Gonzalez, who's found Martinez, but it's well crowded out by Chile and cleared up the pitch. Nicolas Gonzalez was offside by the look of it anyway. Inside to Arangis, looking to return the pass to Isla, but it just runs beyond the fullback. Isla, one of a couple of Chile players who plays here in Brazil. I mentioned the other two in the first half. Isla plays, in fact, right here in Rio, in for Flamengo. Paredes with the foul on Arturo Vidal. We're into double figures. Chile are into double figures for the foul count now. Argentina still one away. Arangis towards Medel, but it's scrambled away and will go out for a Chile throw-in. Mena to take. Maripan to Medel. Maripan. Charged down by Martinez, but he's kept the ball. Finds Meneses, who lays it off to Pulgar. And this is Arangis. Isla. Back to Arangis. Vidal. Palacios. Pulgar, Palacios. And Isla allows that to run out for the throw. Now is the chance to play it inside to Pulgar. Maripan. Paredes needs two bites at it, but heads away, but straight down to Isla. And it's Otamendi who comes in and clears. Now Messi, he makes something happen. Oh, well, Medel slipped and Martinez pulls it back for Messi. Messi, and it's come off him and into the hands of Claudio Bravo, who will be very grateful indeed to be able to clutch that ball to his chest. Here's Mena. Looking for Meneses, who's found Pulgar. Pulgar playing much more dynamically already in this second half, and it's four for Vargas, whose shot is straight at Emiliano Martinez. Well, Vidal's ended up on the ground. Here's Vargas' run. And on the follow-up, Vidal, Chile are explaining to Wilmar Roldan why that ought to be a penalty, and I'm sure Argentina are explaining to him why it definitely shouldn't. I'm not sure how much, I think it was Martinez Cuarta who was sticking his foot out to try and clear. I don't know whether he actually realised Vidal was steaming in like that. Really nice pass from Pulgar. He was playing as essentially an out-and-out defensive midfielder in the first half, and he's already getting a lot further on the pitch. Oh, it's Tagliafico, and he certainly did seem to, well, he was facing the direction Vidal was coming from, so I don't think he's got too much of an excuse. And we're getting a VAR check to see whether this is a penalty. Vidal comes in and clearly gets all of the ball, and Tagliafico gets none of it. Well, none of the football, anyway. I have a feeling that Chile are going to have a spot kick in a second. I'm only guessing, but I would guess that the crucial question is which contact is first, Vidal on the ball or Tagliafico on Vidal. And that certainly seems clear that it's that Vidal gets the ball and the ball's away. What's Mr. Roldan going to give? The penalty. Tagliafico's not happy with it, but Roldan stands firm. Ball, bang. Given how quickly everything happened, and that it perhaps wouldn't have happened but for VAR, you can understand why Argentina are frustrated, but it seems okay to me. Now, Arturo Vidal has scored his last five penalties in a row. Can he make it six? Oh, it's saved! And in! Martinez got a strong arm to it, but Vidal turns in the rebound after it comes back up off the crossbar. Argentina are insisting on something or other. But it's one apiece now. And with that goal, Arturo Vidal becomes Chile's joint fourth top scorer in Copas America. That's his eighth goal in the Copa. He goes level with the great Iván Zamorano, David Arellano, who was a striker who played the 24 and 26 Copas America nearly 100 years ago, and Francisco Molina, one of Chile's stars of the 1950s. Scaloni is insisting that there was a handball somewhere after the penalty was turned away onto the crossbar by Martinez. Are we going to have another video check? 1-1. I'll be play on. Argentina will restart. Otamendi. Daniel Fico. And it's back with Chile. Long ball, and then Bravo gets things going. Oh, with another long ball. Looking for Vidal. Gonzalez has done well to win that. But Chelsea to De Paul. It's found Tagliafico. Gonzalez inside, hits it, and it's going to be a corner. Very well indeed. Palacios. Nice reverse pass to Mena. The Pole's able to block it, and it will be an Argentina goal kick. Martinez Cuarta. Cuarta Martinez. Oh, I apologise to Arturo Vidal for getting all excited. And in my own excitement at the Chile goal, I misidentified the scorer. It's actually Eduardo Barragas, so Vidal remains just joint seventh on the Chilean Copas America scoring charts. But Eduardo Barragas extends his lead because that's his 13th goal for Chile in the Copa America. Down, just waiting for Lisandro Martinez to get to his feet before showing him the yellow card. For this challenge. I think it's fair to call that a centre forwards challenge. Mena de Maripan. It's Pulgar looking for Aranguiz, who sends it back to Medel. A nice ball around the corner from Meneses to Mena. Gets it back to Meneses. He's put it up towards the centre spot, but Vidal's header is straight into Emiliano Martinez's hands. Otamendi. To De Paul. Back to Otamendi. Martinez Cuarta to Paredes, who was caught by Charles Aranguiz. Paredes for Otamendi as Argentina restarts. Tagliafico. Looking for Gonzalez, but it's nicely cut out by Isla. Right with Tagliafico now. It's a throw for Chile. Bravo goes long. And there's no one there. Chilean shirt at least, to receive it from him. Sandro Martinez, Lucas Martinez Cuarta. Vargas now with Otamendi tussling with him. Gets it inside for Aránguiz, who manages to release Meneses. I think it's De Paul who cleared. There's Montiel. Here's De Paul. Otamendi. That's Tagliafico out on the left touchline. Got Gonzalez just ahead of him. He draws the foul and gets things moving again quickly. Which Wilmar Roldán then stops again. Spanish football fans might recognise through the mask one of Argentina's assistant coaches sitting there. That was Pablo Aimar. Story of two set pieces then for the goals so far. Oh, I see Argentina were appealing that the ball had hit Vidal's hand there just before Vargas got to it with his head. Well, once Carlos Palacios has been treated, this will be an Argentina free kick. Just to remind you, he fouled Tagliafico in the process of hurting himself. Messi and Paredes are standing over the set piece. No, they're not. Paredes is in the box, and that's in. And he can't keep his header down. Looks like a double change for Argentina coming up. Angel Di Maria and Ezequiel Palacios coming on. The first player off is Giovanni Lo Celso. Second, presumably, is either Rodrigo De Paul or Leandro Paredes. It is Paredes. That means that Argentina's shape will stay more or less the same. Di Maria might prefer some slightly wider areas to Lo Celso, but in essence it's still a 4-3-3. Free kick to Chile. Gives me time to tell you that Angel Di Maria is winning his 106th cap for Argentina tonight, just two behind Diego Simeone. He's the fifth most capped Argentine of all time. That is, Simeone is currently fifth most capped. Also, didn't get a chance to mention before the start of the match that this is Lionel Messi's 145th cap, which puts him level with Javier Zanetti as the second, joint second most capped Argentines of all time. He is now only two appearances behind his former teammate, Javier Mascherano, who had 147. So the record could belong to Messi by the end of this group stage. Sandro Martinez Cuarta. Bell's battling for it, but it's back with Chile. Pulgar comes away with it, gives it to Medel, back to Maripan. With a very loose ball there. And Di Maria gets his first proper touch of the game. De Paul going down the right. Paul could use some options. He's only got Lisandro Martinez to aim at. And it eventually finds its way to Gonzalo Montiel. Here's Messi. Messi has a go. And Medel heads perhaps a little theatrically over. Argentina will have a corner then. Sends it towards the edge of the box. And Di Maria's there, into a crowd of bodies, and Chile will clear. Here's Meneses. It's well to find Vargas on the left flank. It's a seat to break. Meneses again. Oh, that's loose. Di Maria gets it. And finds Messi on the right. Almost immediately has two men round him. It's the only way you can get the ball off him. Oh, nice footwork from Maripan. Not such a nice pass. It's straight to Rodrigo De Paul. And I'm not really sure what he was doing there. I assume he was trying to find Nicolas Tagliafico, but he didn't look up before playing that. It's Palacios into Vidal. Wants us to believe he's fouled, but Mr. Roldan says play on. Nico Gonzalez cutting in from the left, going outside, weaving inside. To Messi on the edge of the box. Messi! Pushed away by Bravo. And Medel. Very cool head under pressure from Gary Medel there, finding Claudio Bravo rather than just hacking it behind. Otamendi driving forward is brought down by Vidal. Minutes left. There's another free kick for Argentina in Chilean territory. Locked at 1-1, the same scoreline that this fixture produced just a week and a half ago in World Cup qualifying in Argentina. Messi up to the far post. Martinez Cuartas there. Chile clear out to Di Maria on the right. Doing with some options. He's deciding to go in alone. Ooh. Got a cross in, but there was no one lurking or sufficiently quick. Argentina with the throw in though, and Di Maria now has a chance to weave in field. Claudio Bravo can deal with that fairly easily, not too much of a challenging ball. Well, we're going to have another pause in play, I think. To look at one of Claudio Bravo's saves of the day. Argentina haven't given him an awful lot to do. I think it's two saves and the goal. Proper chances have been hard to come by in this match. But when called upon, he's done quite well. Okay. Vargas is the man being stretchered off, but sitting up, you would think he'll be able to walk off once he is off the pitch. And it's an uncontested drop ball to get things going again. Like Vargas is going to be taken off in a second. Blackburn Rovers fans might well recognise one of Chile's substitutes, because Ben Brereton, who came up through Nottingham Forest's academy, has a Chilean mother. Di Maria's free on the right. It's inside and puts it up to the far post, but Gonzalez had tried to go inside Isla's run when the better chance might have been on the outside, and Isla now will lead the charge for Chile down the right. Offloads to Vidal. It's Medel. Across to Maripan. Back to Bravo. Chile can't, well, couldn't this time get beyond halfway with an attempt. Here's Mena. Pulgar. Straight to Otamendi, who doesn't mess about with it. Martinez Cuarta winning the header. Vargas is the man down, so he's continued to play on for now, but I would think that he's going to be one of those subbed in a second, given that we just saw him receiving some treatments a few minutes ago. Here we are then, Brereton, who won one of the youth European Championships a few years ago with England, is going to get his first cap for Chile, the country of his mother's birth, tonight, replacing Carlos Palacios. And the other change, as expected, is Edu Vargas, who is subbed for Cesar Pinares. Similarly to Argentina's two changes, this shouldn't mean too much of a change in shape. Chile, it's two largely like for like substitutions. Mena, Vidal's crowded out, but Medel's doing well under Messi's close attention to evade Argentina's challenge for now. And Di Maria has put the ball out. So Chile will have a throw. Well, it's just an exchange of throw-ins for a minute or so there. Chile made some good progress up the left flank on that basis, but Argentina have it now. Lisandro Lucas Martinez Cuarta. That's why I spent the first half not giving them the two first names. Now Pulgar has a chance to get his foot on the ball and pick a pass. Charles Aránguiz to Vidal. Medel's got Pinares ahead of him, but goes back to Medel. Medel for Pulgar. De Paul's gone a long way up. Forced Bravo into a quick clearance, and Messi has it now. De Paul back to Messi. To Tagliafico. To Gonzalez, sorry. But the cross just caught Lisandro Martinez flat-footed. Yeah. Ezequiel Palacios. Back to Nicolas Otamendi. Otamendi to Martinez Cuarta. To Montiel. De Paul is the man who dropped deep to play this to Otamendi now. There's Palacios. Isla's dispossessed by Gonzalez, and Argentina can build again with De Paul. Finds Messi. Messi looks inside and plays a nice ball in. And Nico Gonzalez is incensed with himself. He knows he should have done better with that. What a lovely pass from Messi. One of those situations where throughout Messi's career, we've all seen him do it so many times, we knew exactly what's going to happen, but if you're the defender trying to prevent it from happening, good luck. And Chile perhaps a bit of a let off there that Nico Gonzalez couldn't get a better header on the end of it. Sergio Aguero, another of the heavily capped Argentine contingent tonight, makes his way on to replace Lisandro Martinez. Vidal. It's making Isla run for that one, and well, Isla's not as young as he used to be. This is Aguero's 98th cap for Argentina, by the way. Here's Brereton. What can he do in his first involvement? Finds Vidal, who's pass was loose, but this has come over to Pulgar, who was offside. Yeah, take your pick really across that line. Three Chileans past the last Argentine. Palacios finds Di Maria. He's going to want to come inside. Di Maria. To De Paul. Antonio Fico. To Messi. The man lying on the floor is Joaquin Correa, who's also just come on for Argentina. So it's another free kick. 8 minutes to go now. This match is ticking down. Are we going to have a winner? Messi considering his options. Sends it in. And Brereton gets it clear. And will now lead the Chilean counter. Finds Meneses. Meneses. Back in towards Brereton, but it was cut out. Arangis. Arangis' pass is asking a little too much of Arturo Vidal. And Argentina will be grateful that that didn't end up rather worse for them. Rodrigo De Paul just having a discussion with Wilmar Roldán, the referee. Toby Avigo did really well to get a touch on that and just move it away from Vidal's run. More substitutions. Gary Medel comes off. Replaced by Enzo Rocco. And the other change will be Vidal, one of the more active players of this match, who is replaced. Tomás Alarcón. There is Alarcón. Finding Isla, back to Pulgar. Bravo's looking long, but no problem for Argentina. Chile will have to settle for a throw-in inside their own half. Another change for Argentina. Gonzalo Montiel has been replaced by Nicolás Molina. Tagliafico wants some options for the throw. He's not being given many. Tries to Paul, it was crowded out, but Argentina immediately win the ball back. And Amendi finds Martinez Cuarta. And Molina will get his foot on the ball for the first time. He released Di Maria, who's cutting inside. The ball just ran away from him. Mena did really well to stab that away from Di Maria. Molina, oh, here's Di Maria. Can he find the space? Well, he could find the space to shoot. He couldn't find the space for the angle, but it's taken a deflection. And Argentina will have a corner. Oh, no, they won't. Referee signals, a little confusing there, but it is a Chile goal kick. Spin of the ball, it did look as if that came off a defender, but oh, it's a free kick. Three and a half minutes to go of the 90. Britain wins the header, but was coming back from an offside position, according to the assistant referee. Mendy to Martinez Cuarta, looking for Di Maria, who tried to take the throw quickly, but thought better to leave it to Molina. Aguero's touch has given it straight to Brereton, and now Chile can counter. Like that though. Oh, but Britain's muscled out Molina and he's cutting in. Finds Charles Aránguiz. Pulgar will take this almost back to the halfway line. Oh, and that's a very nicely spotted ball. Pinares back to, well, all the way back to Rocco. And I've come. There's Bravo. So Mendy tussling with Britain and gets the better of him this time. Well, I think Roldan has given the foul for the initial contact rather than for the rather extended tussle that came about with Di Maria immediately afterwards. Otamendi looking for options. Tagliafico wide on the left. Buys himself a throw-in. Gives it back to Otamendi. De Paul. Molina, Iniesis puts it out for the throw. Agüero chests down to Di Maria. Roldan saw a push on Agüero, and rather than deciding he might see whether it led to something else for Argentina, he's given the free kick straight away. Could be Messi, it could also be De Paul to put this in. He did take a free kick against Colombia in the recent World Cup qualifiers, and it led to a goal. It will be out swinging for him, in swinging for Messi from this position, of course. But it is Messi towards Agüero, who's beaten in the air and is behind for a corner for Argentina as we tick towards stoppage time. Well, we'll take this one, and we're going to have 7 minutes of time added on. Those early VAR checks around the penalty call and then immediately after it. De Paul to Messi, back to De Paul. Angles that towards the 6 yard box, but it's cleared by Mena. Only as far as Di Maria. Di Maria playing a bit of keep ball and then finding Messi via a defender. Palacios. Finds De Paul in space. De Paul's up there and Messi's there with the header. And that's fantastic defending from Rocco, the substitute, after Bravo didn't seem to know where he was. That looked like it could only end in an Argentina goal. But Rocco manages to turn it over, and Argentina have to settle for a corner. De Paul once again offering Messi the short option, which Messi takes. Now Messi will put the in-swinging in, which is headed away, and Messi can't get over the shot enough. Ballooned over the crossbar, and Claudio Bravo will be able to have the goal kick. Looks like Chile are preparing another substitution. They're making another substitution. Meneses, who's had an all-action kind of match, is the man to come off on the left wing. Replaced by Pablo Galdames. With Di Maria harrying him, Argentina come away with the ball through Messi. He does well to find Tagliafico. Tagliafico's cross from very deep indeed, which Chile will eventually will clear. But Molina stops it from going out. Ooh, and Di Maria came together with Pinares, but painful for both of them. But it's going to be a free kick to Chile. We're halfway into stoppage time now. 3.5 minutes left for one of these teams to try and find something, if they can, to claim all 3 points. Molina wants to take a quick throw, but wasn't getting much attention from his teammates. The ball looks loose, Messi can't bring it under control, and Pulgar finds Arangis. Pulgar, here's Mena. And that was far from the best cross of Pinares' career. No one there. Otamendi clears and Agüero's chasing, but Chile maintain the pressure at the moment. Here's Brereton. That's a nice turn. And Otamendi did well at the second attempt to nick it away from Ben Brereton. And Argentina will have a free kick. Here's Di Maria on the right for Argentina. There's Messi now, driving through the centre. It's ended up with Molina. Finds Di Maria, who was trying to find Molina, but the fullback's run was checked. And Bravo has the ball in his hands again. Just 90 seconds left for this Group A encounter. And went for it, but didn't get there, and Martinez Cuarta will come away. Well, it was a free kick to Argentina, in fact. Otamendi pushing forward. Argentina with just one more minute to find the winner, or Chile, of course. It's Argentina who are attacking through Joaquin Correa now. Back to Tagliafico. Otamendi. Martinez Cuarta trying to find an angle of entry into the box. Molina, Messi, Molina, Messi, Di Maria. And I'm not quite sure what Angel Di Maria was expecting to happen there. De Pau to Molina. Eugenio Mena just reminded Molina that he was there. Argentina have a free kick. And again, same drill as before. If it's Messi, it'll be in swinging. If it's De Paul, it'll be out swinging, but it looks like Messi. And he's placed the ball. And this really will be last chance saloon now for Argentina. De Paul is looking as if he might be the one to take it. He will. And it's not a particularly good connection. Pinares driving forward. Finds Brereton, who can't bring it under control. And De Paul comes away with it. Palacios finds Tagliafico. Tagliafico driving into the box. Can he make something happen? He can't. It's a corner. And it looks like Wilmar Roldán will allow this one to be taken. So we have another chance for one or the other nation to find a winner. No short corner this time, unless he's not being given the option of it. That's presumably because Argentina know that as soon as this ball's played out, it's highly likely to mean the end of the match. Well, Rondon's making Messi wait for something. I'm just wondering when Tagliafico's cross went in. Mauricio Isla, wondering whether they think it might have hit him on the hand and whether that hand was in an unnatural position. Because I didn't see anybody from Argentina's side try and claim this. It looks like it might be something the video assistant wants to check himself. Here we are, see. It hits Rocco and then bounces up onto Isla's elbow. It's in. And it's not. It's cleared away. De Paul finds Martinez Cuarta, and that will be that. Wilmar Roldán brings to a close the first match of Group A of the 2021 Copa America. Lionel Messi's brilliant free kick in the first half gave Argentina a 1-0 advantage, but Eduardo Vargas got to Arturo Vidal's saved penalty first to stab it in. And that 1-1 is the score that both sides eventually have to settle for at the end of a hard-fought, if not always highest quality, encounter. Thanks for joining us.